Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Open Source Tonight. Today, folks, I've got a cool piece of software called Qprompter to show you, so let's go take a look. So, folks, if we take a look over here, this is Qprompt. I wanted to call it Qprompter, but Qprompt, I should say. And it's pretty cool software. So if we actually run over to a terminal, we can install it like this. Sudo snap install. And then we're going to type Qprompt and, you know, enter the login and all that good stuff. Here we go. So it's downloading it right now. So what Qprompt is it is a software teleprompter. So if you ever looked at like news or things like that, where they often use teleprompters in like the studio, this allows you to do the same thing with like a cheap monitor and a proper teleprompter rig and hook it up to a computer via like HDMI. So folks, this is Qprompter. Again, I wanted to call it Qprompter, but it's Qprompt. And so we can start this. So if I actually hit, let's see, start prompting. Yeah, there it goes. I can full screen this. And now this feels a lot like if you've seen a professional teleprompter before, and like, you know, television behind the scenes and stuff like that. This looks a lot like what the operator would see, or what the reader would say, the actual talent would see. And you read the part that's inside this little highlight area. And again, normally this would be put on a monitor with a special mirror kind of thing that sets almost like a map box, if you know what a map box is, but not a map box, on the front of a broadcast camera. You can do it on a cinema camera. You can even get them now for like a DSLR or a mirrorless camera, something you could actually afford. And you could then read a script like this. And a lot of YouTubers and such do use these, so that way they can sound very professional. I've had a lot of issues reading from a teleprompter, so I've never really done it on these videos. I kind of just do things off the cuff, and hopefully it works. But we can change a bunch of things. We can change like the reading range. So this is like where it is, so I can put it at the bottom. You can set timers. So this is pretty cool. So like you could have a timer, and so we could turn that on, and that actually times, if I understand right, how long it takes for you to read. Now, what I really like is actually the countdown clock. This is really cool. So I'm going to say auto start. I'm going to set a countdown, and I'm going to say 8 seconds. I'm going to hit start, and you can see this would be useful. So that way you can have like the beginning of a broadcast or something and time this up. And here we go. As soon as we get there, it goes. Now that the countdown's over, it's actually scrolling the text for me. And as you can see, there is actually the ability to put images in it too. So if I come up here, and this is all editable, so I could say I don't want that. Maybe I don't want any of this. I can just come in here and remove all of it. So what if we say test and then new line, test and then new line, test? Well, that would work. So that's something that we can do. We can turn on different pointers. We can set a background color and such. So maybe we set red for fun. So now we have a red teleprompter. Now, I mean, the industry standard is to do black. And I think that looks good. So we'll use that. But, you know, at least as far as more of this, the industry standard, that's what I like anyway. So we can flip it, because again, normally it would be flipped. So yeah, I mean, you know, simple stuff. You can edit these and save them. But anyway, everybody, I hope you enjoyed today's video. Thanks for watching so much. And until next time, goodbye, everybody.
And action.